I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome back, Cougars. Today is Wednesday, January 8th. Welcome to SCTV News. I'm Mrs. Harold.
And I'm Dr. Cohen. We hope you had a fun winter break, and we also hope you're well rested and ready to begin the spring term and also the very first term of the new decade. Seniors, you're less than 5 months away from graduation.
The most exciting event of the winter is now just a few weeks away. Winter Formal takes place on Saturday, February 1st from 6 to 10 p.m. at the Sheraton San Diego Hotel. Guest passes are available on the school website, and they must be completed by January 29th. Tickets go on sale at the finance office and the student store tomorrow. They are $20 with an ASB card and $25 without. Prices will increase each week, so get yours now.
Our custodians worked hard over winter break to get our campus ready for the start of this term, and we want to keep it looking good all the way up to summer break. How can we do that, you ask? By taking care of this place. And we have some important advice for students. Jack Hernandez, McKenna Summers, and Andre Rodriguez have this special report.
Cougars, we need to take care of our school. Our campus is always getting repaired and cleaned due to our actions, costing us $20,000 to $28,000 a year, and that's just Chromebooks.
Kind of depends. For Chromebook repairs, a lot of the repairs can be done in-house by Mr. Pan, but sometimes we have to send them out to a company called EdTech. Last year, it was about $23,000 to repair the Chromebooks. So just kind of depends. Mr. Pan, and he's gotten a couple TAs now, are able to kind of help with the repairs in-house if we can do that.
Not only do Chromebooks get wrecked, but also parts of the school.
We do feel like 99.99% of the time, Cougars are taking care of this place. As human beings, though, we usually look for things that are out of place, broken, or missing. And so when we see something that's broken, we tend to focus on it. Like everybody's probably seen the bench in the quad where the tabletop, you know, has been disconnected. You know, we're actively working to fix that. We've got to order a new one and get it installed. But you know, when we see that, it's an eyesore, and it definitely takes a toll on the mental, status of everybody in our community. And so we want to make sure that, you know, we do get things repaired and corrected right away. And we hope that the Cougars students feel that we're doing a good job in taking care of the facilities, because we do care. And we want people to have an enjoyable, positive experience while they're here at school.
The new QR code systems implemented into the bathrooms are on campus. It's just one of the ways staff has tried to combat the misuse of school property.
One of our Cougar Congresses, the second to last one, it was brought up that more students want to voice their input about concerns they have about facilities, but they didn't know the best way to do it. So we came up with a form. It's called the Facility Concern Form, and it should be posted in every restroom. It's got a little QR code that if you use your phone with your camera, it'll take you straight to a Google form, and that, when you submit it, it submits your email address and it gives your concern to myself and to our facility manager. And we take those very seriously. So we're always looking for ways to improve. And if Cougars see something that they feel like can be improved, we want them to go ahead and submit a concern form. If it's super urgent, obviously don't hesitate to just grab one of the administrators and let us know right about it.
Of course, the destruction of school property doesn't go unpunished, and people who misuse those materials often end up with a price to pay. Be thoughtful about what you're doing at school. You never know who might be watching.
If they get caught, which is the hard part, we have cameras everywhere, and that's usually how kids get caught, or someone tells on them. I know snitches get stitches, but guess what? There's always somebody willing to tell on you, so be careful. Always eyes watching. So it depends on the price, the cost of replacing it and fixing it. So they can get a referral, they could get suspended. If they've had prior issues, they could actually go up for expulsion if it was a large amount of damage, and price-wise, if it took a lot of money to replace what they had damaged. We could send them to respectful relations, which kind of is a intervention that would help them work through why they should be respectful of property and people and other people's things, especially. It's not theirs.
Students around school think that the materials should be treated with respect since they don't really own them.
I think school property should be respected. We're here every single day, and you know, this is what we have to be around, and you don't want your home trash, so.
Yeah?
Yes, very much so.
Because we're not even paying for it. It probably costs a lot. And like when people break them, I'm just like, oh, next time be more careful. Like, you probably shouldn't do that.
I mean, I didn't pay for it, so I feel like anything I didn't pay for, I shouldn't be able to do whatever I want with it, you know? Well, I mean, like, if you break a Chromebook, like, I feel like that's, like, disrespectful, you know, because, like, you didn't pay for it. And also, like, some people use Chromebooks to, like, learn, and if you're, like, destroying something to help somebody learn, I think that's wrong. So, like, yeah. I mean, yeah, because, like, you know, the school campus is public, and I feel like everybody's, like, walking through the quad and stuff. I feel like, since you go here, I feel like you should respect it because it's, like, a place of learning and, you know, it's important to be here and stuff. So, yeah.
Absolutely. Because this is where we learn and this is where we prepare for our future, so I would believe so that it would be a place that we should take care of.
Cougars, remember to take care of this place as if it is your home, because it is for 4 years. For SCTV News, I'm Jack Hernandez.
That's all the news we have for you today. Have a great first week back. Rah-rah, Cougars!
Cougar pride!
Get some!